Today we are going to discuss integration topics, and so we'll talk about 8 to 10 integration topics, starting from what you call event management. Then we'll look at global tracking and tracing interface, then GTS. Then we'll discuss about product compliance, and then in analytics, extended warehouse management, then resource planning, then yard logistics, logistics business network, and then we'll end with blockchain, CRM, and GIS. So today's session will be more trying to understand the integration aspects around transportation management. So it's very important that in today's landscape, in a customer, you'll find a lot of integrations around transportation management. So therefore, from that perspective, it is important that we understand these integration topics. So let us understand integration topics. We'll start with event management. Okay. So event management, let's understand that to start with, the event management typically looks into the control processes, track and trace processes, and the visibility processes. So in a real world of event management system, the events are to be controlled, and they have to be tracked, and tracing is so important. And then everybody expects a visibility from that standpoint. A geographical visibility, a graphical visibility is what one expects. Tracking of certain vehicle resources also is what one expects. And then controlling of the process in terms of the events, what are the rules, and what are the next steps which are required to be performed. So those are things which are necessary. And from a event management functions perspective, so there are certain things which are basic functions which event management performs. Like, for example, notifications. So we understand that any deviations occur, then notifications have to be raised, and then the simulation. So if any such occurrence happen, then what will be the, is it possible to simulate a particular situation? What in terms of solutioning, simulation for solution perspective, and then how do you control, any dependencies or any necessities, which need to be initiated, those things. And then how do you measure and analyze, and so on and so forth. So event management would have a typical functionalities around it, which need to be tracked. And then because you need to respond in a real-time situation. So tracking and tracing has to be done in a real-time situation, and how these business objects are going to respond, and how the system is configured, how the triggering happens from stage to stage is something which we need to understand. So basic essential characteristics of an event. So obviously, event is like it's something which probably has certain characteristics. Which has something like a repeatability, then it will have certain things like a date and time, or expected event date, expected message or time. So these kind of things which are a part of your event characteristics. So and this event occurs, it could occur across the life cycle of a particular transportation activity. So beginning of the event handler cycle. So it probably might start right at the beginning, and then end of event handler cycle. So it might end. So the loading and loading of the real world operations are depicted here. And then the system based process representation, which is represented in the system, is mentioned here. So the real world operations comprises of your unloading PU truck or late departure, accident, or no proof of delivery sent, or some certain events which are typical events or which are reported in the system, and then how the system responds based on certain rules and configurations, etc., is what event management is all about. And then events basically are categorized. So these events could be regular occurring events, which probably you could expect them, like proof of delivery, not proof of delivery, no proof of delivery is sent. Maybe it's a sort of a not a regular event, rather it is something which may be an ignored one, or rather something which was not reported. Early or late events in terms of departures and things like that. Unexpected events, accident could be an unexpected event, unreported events, these kind of stuff. And so event management itself has got a architecture, in terms of where it stands, and in terms of the SAP transportation management, the legacy systems, the analytics, and then the event management itself. So what could be the trigger sources? So typically it will have some trigger source, the transactional object or master data object, process in business systems. Anything which is deviating could be the trigger points, trigger source points could be there. And then a lot of internal activities which happen within the event management system. And then on the user side, one could browse the browse through a browser window, or do analytics in terms of